Instead of that, let's put together a computer.
There's the computer parts, the case, and there's the existing computer. I already took the sides off of this thing. This case has a bunch of these fans on it. It has one here, it has one here, and here, and it has this giant one on the top. And they all have these little LEDs going around the outside, blue LEDs. But since I'm going to put this in my bedroom, I've already covered them up with black electrical tape. So that way I don't have a nightlight anytime that I have the computer on a long download or a render or a compile. The front panel of this case, it has a little indicator for the hard drive activity, but it doesn't have one to say that the computer is on. It's expecting you to go by the LEDs and the fans, which will always be on whenever the power is on. I'm starting with the power supply. I'm pretty sure that's the right thing to do. Unfortunately, I don't have the instructions because that's a PDF, which is on that computer over there that's disconnected. The motherboard, at least, came with a good manual. This power supply comes in this felt. I want to say it's a felt bag. I don't know why. It's partially modular. It has all these cables attached. Hopefully those are the most important ones. And it has this bag of additional ones that you can plug in. These are the cables that you can't remove, and any additional ones would plug in here. The power supply goes here on the base of the case. And then the plug will go over here. And there are these little rubber feet at the bottom that the power supply rests on. Let's see if I can get it in there. Not quite. There's that little metal tab thing it has to get under. And that's the end of that chapter. And since next I have to put in the motherboard, I think I will be taking off my socks and attaching the anti-static wristband. The motherboard comes with these things. Oh, I bought more of these things, oh well. SATA cables, faceplate. And this dealy, this is for if you have more than one graphics card. And this is for the little connector things for the front. Not entirely sure how I'm supposed to get this out of the bag without touching things. Well, let's see how it goes. Motherboard didn't come with any screws, so I need to figure out which screws go in there that came with the case. Probably these small ones. I have to somehow get these cables out of the way so that the motherboard can go in. Let's see if I can find where the screws fit. One screw is already in for some reason. I'm finding it useful to use the pickle plucker to place the screws. Thank you. Look, a useful thing I just figured out. This bag came with two kinds of screws. The ones that I want for the motherboard are these ones that don't have a lip. Don't use these ones. And now that I've opened the other bag of screws, I think that these were the wrong screws altogether. It's probably supposed to be these ones. Not these ones. But these ones, they have the same thread, but the head is bigger and there appear to be more of them, because there aren't enough of the other one. And also these things. If I attach these to the case, then I'll be able to attach the motherboard with 9 screws instead of only 6. So I think the motherboard needs to come out again. So now I'm wondering if maybe it was supposed to be these screws, because there are only 8 of the screws that I'm using this time. Not these ones, those are different, but these ones. 9, 10, 11, and I need 9. No, it couldn't be, because the threads are different. I don't know, I guess I'll just have to use one of the ones that I was using first. So now I have 8 of these screws, and one of that. Anybody else know why there's 8 of one screw that fits and 4 of another screw that fits, but I need 9 screws? Let's see if this fits on here from the outside, because it didn't like being on the inside. Before I install the CPU, I'm going to try to hook up the power to the motherboard and see if it beeps at me. I have the motherboard connected here. Now there's supposed to be something hooked up there for power. And that doesn't say it's the CPU, but this power thing that would fit there says CPU. So I think this is for the CPU. So I'm not going to connect that. The motherboard has a little button right there to turn it on without having the front panel connected. First I switch this on, and I'm going to use this, I guess it's a button pusher tool. Push the button. No. Now that's connected, and I'll try again. The power came on the speakers. The button. Oh, the button's lit up. There's no beep though. It's time for CPU then. Here's the CPU. And there's this little arrow here. And there should be some kind of matching arrow on the motherboard where the CPU goes. Little tiny pins. That should be the CPU. Pegs on the fan. These have little arrows on them. Don't do that unless you want to take it out. I hope that's good.